Hello and welcome to Clinical Exam Series with Dr. Piro. Today we are going to be discussing the 5 C's. Now, as any clinician will tell you, irrespective of the advances in medical technology, history taking still remains the cornerstone of clinical practice. And one of the key aspects of history taking is the history of presenting complaints. So you have a patient who has presented with cough of 2 week duration. The history of presenting complaint is that aspect of the history where you are going to find out the possible etiologies of that particular symptom. The 5 C's is a mnemonic that stands for the character of that complaint, the cause, C-A-U-S-E, of that complaint, the core, C-O-U-R-S-E, of that complaint, the complications that may have arisen as a result of that particular complaint, and finally, the care that has been given to the patient so far. So the 5 C's help us to ask questions in the history of presenting complaint. And both the positive and the negative responses to the questions asked here are important in the history of presenting complaint. There are videos that discuss individually the common symptoms that are usually presented with by patients: headache, joint pain, abdominal pain. There are individual videos that discuss with how to characterize each of those particular symptoms. Now, the cause of that complaint. The cause is why we go to medical school. This is why we spend almost 2 years learning pathology. And to be able to remember quickly the possible causes of a particular symptom, there are various acronyms we can use. There's Tinkerbell, there's Vindicate, but for the purpose of this video, I'm going to use Vindicate. Now, Vindicate stands for vascular, inflammatory, neoplastic, degenerative or deficiencies, idiopathic or intoxications, congenital causes, autoimmune or allergic causes, traumatic causes, and then E will be for endocrine causes. So this acronym Vindicate can help you remember the possibilities, the various possibilities when it comes to the etiology of a particular disease. In terms of the details of each symptom, these are discussed in the individual videos that discuss the common symptoms that are usually presented with in the emergencies. The cause of the complaint. Has the complaint worsened over time? For example, the patient presented with cough that was productive of sputum and now has worsened to coughing up of blood. This will tell you that the symptoms are getting worse. Or has the complaint been stable over the past 2 weeks? Or has the complaint actually reduced? The next C will be the complication. A patient presented with cough of 2 years duration. With that increased intra-abdominal pressure for 2 years duration, there's a possibility of hernias occurring in that patient. So these are possible complications that may arise that you should ask for. The last C here will be the care given so far. And it is very important to always ask for what has been done for the patient. Reason why is because in a bid for relatives and even the patient to care for himself, they might have taken substances which may have worsened the particular complaint that they may have come with. It's good to ask for drugs that the patient have taken, herbal drugs, prescribed medications, homeopathic medications, home remedies. Just make sure you know exactly what the patient has done. Another reason why is because if the patient, for example, has taken antibiotics for the cough without any relief, then in your management option, you probably avoid the particular antibiotic that the patient has already used without any reason. In addition to the 5 C's, after the character of the complaint, the cause of the complaint, most clinicians will advise you to bring the review of system here. The reason why is because after asking the cause and the course of that complaint, you can begin to ask questions of other particular systems that might have been affected. We know cough is majorly cardiorespiratory. This is where you are going to begin to ask questions if there are neurological symptoms, there are gastrointestinal symptoms, there are urogenital symptoms, to make sure you have a full picture of what might be wrong with the patient. And this also makes the history of your presenting complaint more comprehensive. So once again, the 5C stands for the character of the complaint, the cause of the complaint, the course of the complaint, the complication, and the care given so far. Don't forget, somewhere in the middle there, you are going to put the review of system. And lastly, there are videos that individually discuss the common symptoms that patients present with, as well as examination videos, procedures, and even picture tests. Thank you guys for watching, and see you in the next video.